What's up, guys? Jeff Cavalier, ATHLEAN-X.com. Today, we're going to talk all about workout soreness and tell you what you need to know about workout soreness, whether you should be chasing it because you feel like it's a prerequisite for growth, or whether you maybe shouldn't be focused so much on it, or whether there's even things that are more important than it. You see, when it comes to workout soreness and anything here on this channel, we try to put the science back in strength. And we try to do it in that sort of no BS way so you understand what it is that you're going after. When we talk about training and soreness, really what we're discovering is that, and there's a lot of research that goes back and forth on whether or not this is true, but what we see is workout soreness is generally created by eccentric training. And there's a reason for that. Concentrically, what we're doing is, meaning we're shortening a muscle with tension. If I were to flex my bicep as hard as I possibly can here, flex, 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 flex hard, it really actually hurts. There's tension in this muscle. I'm squeezing as hard as I can, but it's shortened. There's a shortening here. If I were to have tension in the opposite direction, eccentrically, when I'm lowering and stretching, and I'll show you here on an incline curl in a second, now what I've done here is if I look at this band in place of my muscle, instead of having this where I'm actually pulling and pushing as hard as I can, there's tension on the ends of the band, I'm pushing, pushing, pushing them towards each other. It looks like it's fine, it's intact. However, if I put tension with the elongation, these little rips that were already in this band are getting worse and worse and worse. So what happens is you're getting these sort of micro tears and damage in your muscle fibers when you do eccentric training, meaning loaded elongation of the muscle itself. That actually is what sparks muscle growth. So if we look at it here in an example, I could take a dumbbell, and again, I can curl it here. And as I'm curling up, I definitely have tension in the bicep. That's why it's flexing, and it's shortening. And concentric-only training, ironically, can be done without producing much soreness, if any at all. Okay, so when I elongate, though, I'm getting a stretch on the muscle and tension. So that's doing that band effect. It's pulling it apart. It's creating the micro tears and the damage. And people that sort of don't focus on eccentric training and they just kind of drop the dumbbells without really allowing the tension, there's no tension there. So if you do your eccentrics and you don't concentrate on slow eccentrics, you're actually missing a lot of the tension. You're getting elongation here, but not a lot of tension because you've let it go. So if you're gonna look for soreness or chase after soreness, you'll get it only if you slow down the eccentrics, not just by doing eccentrics alone. And as I said, other forms of concentric training like sled pushing or many of the Olympic lifts like cleans or snatches, there's not a real eccentric portion of that lift. And a lot of times you can do those without producing soreness. We even have a phase in one of our programs where we do back-to-back training, concentric focus on a muscle group on a certain day, and we come back eccentrically the next day, realizing that we're not going to be very sore from the day before. So, what the hell am I sleeve doing up here? So the fact is that if you're going to chase soreness, you're going to get it that way. Now, is it even necessary? Well, here's the interesting part. It is necessary, I believe, because you're looking to have that adaptive stress. If you're not creating stress on the muscle, you're not going to create the stimulus for growth. And keep that in mind. If you're training for strength, soreness isn't necessarily even what you're after. You don't have to become sore to get stronger. Well, if you're looking for hypertrophy, knowing what we know about eccentric training and overload and what it can do to the muscle to create the stimulus for growth, we want to get that effect. However, here's where people screw it up and here's where people won't tell you the truth. And I think a lot of times this is where the studies kind of fall apart. If you're training, you're looking at about 30 or 40 or 60 minutes or say in a day of your day, your full 24-hour day. You might get everything right there. You might do everything I just showed you to create muscle soreness. And the next day you wake up, or 48 hours later you wake up, and you're sore. But did you grow? If you didn't do everything else right, the stuff that you do in the other 23 hours, like eat right, supplement if you're gonna supplement, sleep adequately, sleep right, in other words, sleep for recovery. If you don't do any of that other stuff, you're not gonna grow. Just because you were sore, you didn't support your efforts in the gym. And I always say here, it's sort of like, I can do the best I can to try to get you to do the right things in the gym, but I can't walk you through the other 23 hours of your day and have you do everything right. And this is where people don't have the commitment. It's really, really difficult to do everything right, and you gotta do a lot of things right to do everything right for 23 other hours of the day. That's why dieting and eating right is really so hard, because we can all make it to the gym, but we can't do the other half of the other portion of this for all those many hours. So you can certainly be sore and not grow. So that's, I think, where a lot of people come to the conclusion that soreness doesn't necessarily equate to muscle growth. I think it does if you're doing everything that you need to do to support your hard efforts in the gym. Now, as far as those people that say, I never get sore when I train, never, ever, ever. If you want me to show you how to do that, I will give you a workout, and I promise you I'll make you sore as shit. But I'm not gonna kill you or do crazy things. I'm just gonna show you exactly how to do that. Let me know, I'll make a video on that, in a separate video, I'll show you exactly a routine that you can do to get sore all over. But today we're discussing whether or not it's even necessary for growth. That's sort of my two cents, and I think it's on the right track. So let me know, guys, what you want me to cover here on this channel. I'll do my best to bring the ideas and the things that you want me to do. And if you're looking for a program that kind of puts the science back in strength, that won't bullshit you along the way, that is ATHLEAN-X. It's what we try to do better than anybody. You can head to ATHLEAN-X.com right now and get our training program. All right, guys, I'll see you back here again soon. See ya.